Happy Thanksgiving, Corona. I'm Wade Savage. This is dinner. And this is cdstv. Hey, you.
Who, me?
Yeah, you. Pay attention. This is important. The next book club meeting is happening tomorrow in Miss Glick's rooms, E235 at 2:15. Everybody is welcome, and your input is important as we will be picking our next selection. See you there. Great job logging those receipts at Chandler Fashion Center in support of the School Sense program fundraiser. Corona is climbing and is currently in 9th place. Please take note of the special deals and bonus point opportunities on the new flyer. And especially is important that January will be double points month. Save all holiday receipts and turn them in during the month of January to earn the maximum points. We can win this, guys. And here's Mrs. Forbes with the CDSTV 90 second lesson.
Hi Corona, Mrs. Forbes here, and I'm here to tell your brain how our bodies have a language of their own. Welcome back to 90 second lessons. It may be the only chance you get. Were you aware that up to 93% of the way human beings communicate with each other is through body language? Let's start the clock. When you are giving a presentation, did you know that hand gestures give listeners confidence in the speaker? Unless, of course, the gestures are crude or disrespectful. I would avoid those. But otherwise, using two hands above the waist reflects complex thinking. Mentally divide your audience into thirds and give each section their own eye contact and attention. Take the time to give one person eye contact when directly asking a question or making comments. It will make that person and everyone around them feel that you are making direct eye contact with them. Finally, move around the room. It looks like you are animated and makes you look a lot more confident. Second, it's going to happen. Someday you're going to have to look for a job. I'm sorry. But when you're in an interview, avoid nervous gestures such as rocking back in your chair, repeatedly shaking your foot, or even drumming your fingers. You don't want to look like the type of employee that can't stay focused. Also, don't cross your arms, slouch, or stare blankly. Instead, sit up straight, lean slightly forward to that person, not occasionally to show interest, but not too much. You don't want to look like a bobblehead. Finally, avoid strong perfumes or colognes. All right, we got to hit the pause on the clock here. Guys, I know that Axe commercials have convinced you that you'll be a ladies' man by wearing it, but quite frankly, it smells like bug spray and nobody likes it, so you just need to stop. All right, on that note, here's some advice for when you are talking to somebody you like. Your body, hands, and feet should be facing the person so they know that you are fully engaged in the conversation. Use extended eye contact, then shyly look away and back again. Move towards the person and close the space between you. Also, guys, if you see a girl touching her hair a lot, it means she's probably into you. Don't touch your face, though. Itching any part of your face is a nervous gesture that may indicate that you are not being completely honest. The most important part of body language is that most of the time, it's not what you say, but how you say it. You can just ask these guys. Well, it looks like my time is up. Hopefully, you can tell from my body language that I'm a bit relieved. Tune in next time for a quick lesson from your CDS staff.
I'm back, Corona. Thanks, Mrs. Forbes. Congratulations to Pranav Balaki, the Corona Del Sol nominee for the ASU Leadership Scholarship. Pranav will now move forward in the scholarship competition against students across the state. Good luck, Pranav.
Now for the CDSTV original sketch.
I'll turn the wall to the dangerous place. And my job to tackle it. I'm Altrud, and this is Red Whistle's Wall.
It appears I got my arm stuck under this here rock. There seems to be only one way out. It appears I have cut off the wrong arm. Crikey.
Well, I managed to escape from that rock. I made a costume change, and somehow my arm grew back. That's the power of black market surgery.
Well, it appears the rock that I got stuck in just so happened to be Plymouth Rock. You know what that means? We have to recreate the first Thanksgiving. First, we're gonna need a turkey. Second, we're gonna need some pumpkins. And finally, we're gonna need some cranberries. So let's get started. First, the turkey. Now, unfortunately, turkeys are an endangered species in this environment. But luckily, I found the last one.
Excuse me, turkey. Would you like to join my Thanksgiving feast?
I always wanted to be stuffed.
Next, the pumpkins. Now there's only one place where we can find pumpkins. It looks like we're gonna have to bottle with the Indians. Again.
I will give you orange for pumpkin.
What?
I will give you 2 oranges for pumpkin.
What are you talking about? I'm not even that kind of Indian.
Final deal. I will give you square foot land for pumpkin.
No.
Now is the time for grace. Dear one and almighty space monster, thank you so much for creating Walmart, in which we can buy this cheap and enjoyable food. Let's dig in. Happy Thanksgiving, everybody.
Attention seniors, if you're contemplating applying for one of the graduation speaking positions, don't think about it too long, because today is the last day to submit an application. Go to the Coronadosa website and click on the graduation info tab for more information. Completed applications must be submitted to Ms. Centeni in the library no later than 3 p.m. today.
Well, that's all we have for you today, Corona. Have a good Thanksgiving. I'm Wade Savage.
And I'm Jamie Zone.
And this was cdstv.
Just because you feed me well, and you made me talk dirty in a pink hotel. Driving me to see.